There are many different ways to trim a clip in Final Cut Pro. Certainly one of the most popular is to leave the playhead in one position and drag to trim the clip to the playhead. When we do this, we see the image changing in the canvas, as well as a new timecode value. Another popular way to trim is to simply enter a new duration value, and we can accomplish this by right-clicking on the clip in the timeline and choosing to adjust the duration value. We should all be trying to use more keyboard commands and trying to get away from mousing around the interface. On the keyboard, there are two sets of trim tools, and they have the same two functions. The bracket keys and the period and comma keys function identically. When the edit of a clip is highlighted, the keys will either increase or decrease the duration of the clip, and if the clip itself is highlighted, the keys will move the clip forward or back. In either case, if the shift key is held down, the amount of change will be modified by a predetermined amount that is specified in the user preferences under the editing tab. By default, the amount of change is one frame, and the modified amount is specified under multi-frame trim size. When editing the duration of a clip, the manner in which the edit is highlighted is very relevant. Depending on which portion of the edit is highlighted, there are various edits performed. When both the outgoing and incoming edits are highlighted, the trim acts like a roll edit and trims both clips equally. If there is only one side of the edit highlighted, the trim acts like a ripple edit, changing the duration of the clip and moving the affected clips accordingly. The keyboard command used to toggle between the three states is U. When a clip is highlighted, there is no limit to how far the clip can be moved. Simply put, the limit is until there is a clip collision. However, there is no limit to the amount of clips that can be highlighted when moving clips. Only that once one clip has a collision, all clips stop moving. Both functions work in multi-track scenarios. To highlight multiple edits or tracks, simply hold down the command key while selecting. For more on efficient Final Cut Pro and Final Cut Studio workflows, visit GeniusDV and look into receiving some of our formal training while enjoying some of our site's many resources.